gotta go do chores. Fuck. I'm gonna find the other glove. There it is.
So.
What's up?
And it's just. Something really weird happened last night, and I really wanted to talk about it because it just freaked me the fuck out, you know? So.
Yeah.
And I just can't get sleep over it because it freaked me out so bad, and you know, it's, so what happened was, I went outside, and keep in mind there's like a snowstorm going on, so that's my first stupid decision.
Yeah, tell me something I don't know.
And there was blood in the snow. There was fucking blood in the snow, and I decided to follow it. Because maybe I thought, hey, maybe an animal got hurt or something, or, you know? Or maybe there's somebody who got hurt, and I could possibly help. So I stupidly followed it, and I found, it was like a sled or something. It was just absolutely drenched in blood, and I saw it, and I ran, right? Because, you know, it looked like somebody got fucking absolutely murdered. And as I was going to the door, and this is the scariest part, this is what made me not sleep. I heard this growl behind me, and not like directly, but a few feet away. I turn around and I see this thing. It was like this dog or something. It like had multiple heads and shit, and I noticed it was gnawing on like a human arm, and it just looked weird, and then it noticed me, and I was like, what the fuck? And then it just started to run at me, and it almost like attacked me or something. Oh fuck. I don't know what it was.
Are you sure it wasn't just a bad dream or like some kind of hallucination?
I have no fucking clue. Because I don't really hallucinate. I don't, you know, there's no mental illness history. There's no. And it definitely didn't feel like no bad dream. Because I can tell.
Are you sure it wasn't just like a stray dog that was out?
Definitely ain't.
Or.
Too big to be a big. You know,
like I.
Like, it was all fucked up and shit. Like, you should have seen it, because it had... I don't know what the fuck it was, because it literally had more than one head on it. Eating a little... And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I don't know...
Alright.
If I'm going crazy or what.
Alright. I hope you don't mind, but... Do you think it'd be okay if I, like, researched about this for you? Like, right. Just look for, like, what you're describing so I can try and get something down for you?
Yeah. Plus, my house does have history right. That I do know from my parents because they told me about it. But, yeah, they were, like, out of town for the week.
What kind of history?
I don't know. Just a very weird history. That, like, that's all they're telling me. But the house is definitely old. It's, you know, there's just weird things about it. Weird design choices. So that's another thing to keep in mind.
Yeah.
So do try to research on the house if you can. And let me know what you find.
Alright. So, alright, I'll tell you as soon as I can.
Alright. Talk to you later.
Alright. I'll talk to you later.
Peace.
See ya.
See ya. damn thing.
Alright. Before you say anything about what's going on, I need to tell you something.
Yeah?
You told me to look into your house, what was going on, and I did. Holy fucking shit. My question is, how did you not know this stuff? Why did you not know this before you moved? How did people not tell you this?
I don't know. My parents never told me, and
the person who built that house that you're in right now was a Satan worshiper.
What the fuck?
Yep.
What the fuck did he do in the house? Because obviously there's
sacrificed,
shit.
Sacrificed, lynched. So much just unbearable stuff. He was killed by the police back in, I want to say, like, it's 1993, it said. And from what people have said that have come into your normal investigations, the spirits, there's spirits in those, the house you're in. And they're, and from everyone, from what everyone has said, they are aggressive. Some even call them demons. Dude, are you crying? Dude, what the fuck happened? Fuck.
fucking cockroaches?